This is BBC World News, our top story this hour, and that is that officials in China have revised upwards by 50% the number of people who have died of COVID-19 in Wuhan. That's the city where the pandemic started. Well, let's get more on that story now and talk to our China media analyst, Carrie Allen, who joins me from her home. Carrie, good to see you. So many people are saying, of course, this is a cover-up because it's such a huge leap in the figures, 50%. How is the Chinese media reporting it?
Well, if there are comments from people that this is a cover-up, they're not seeing them in mainland China. So what's actually happening on Sina Weibo, which is what people use instead of Facebook or Twitter, is that there are lots of messages that are very pro-government coming onto these platforms. Thousands of comments from people saying that it's good that the government is now giving transparency. And this is normally indicative of what's known as the 50 cent party. And these are people who are paid by the government 50 cents, a small amount of money, to post messages in line with the government's message. So people are only seeing positive government messages in relation to this, not any kind of anger about the government having covered this up.
And is it important for Chinese officials to show Wuhan as being on top of this, that the terrible times are behind Wuhan, there's only good things ahead as well?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, this whole week since Wuhan opened up, and it's almost been like a happy ever after story. There's been lots of positive messages about the medical specialists and the authorities and the good work that they've done to bring Wuhan out of this crisis. And this shows us the timing that this announcement has been released. You know, it's not been announced earlier because that would have really troubled people. So this timing at the moment of this being announced, that yeah, more than 50% of the number of deaths are reported than we initially realized. So the figure went from 2,500 up to 3,000, more than 3,000. People thought that was the original full figure of throughout China. There were roughly 3,300 cases, but now this increase takes it up to 4,600 cases in China. So a huge development in the country.
And Carrie, throughout this crisis, has there been any criticism on any platforms of the government's response or different stories emerging from different places about how the figures can't possibly be right because, people are reporting that they've got family members dying at home, for instance, other stories like that?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I'm thinking back to the early stages of January when I was first covering this story. We were hearing of cases in Wuhan, and then we started hearing of cases in South Korea and Thailand, but we didn't hear anything about other places in mainland China. And it was very much assumed that the government, local governments, were covering this up because they were waiting on the authority of the central government telling them when to announce these figures. So all along, people have been critical of this all over mainland China. But in Wuhan, there have also been cases of journalists on the ground trying to report and going to hospitals. And I mean, we know of two cases where people have done this and they've been arrested and we haven't heard of them since.
And Carrie, we are now seeing, particularly in the US, President Trump, Mike Pompeo, talking about various theories about how the virus has spread, and from this lab in Wuhan being one theory. How is the Chinese government responding to that and to criticism from other countries of how it's handled the crisis?
Well, there's one report today in Global Times, which is one of the most influential newspapers in China, which is saying that China doesn't have to answer to the US or to anybody. It's releasing these figures now of these extra deaths that we didn't realize, because it's saying that it's carried out its investigation, it has this virus under control, and it just absolutely refuses to listen to any countries that are critical, because China is really the only country that's got this under the curve at the moment.
Carrie, good to have your thoughts. Thanks for joining us, our China media analyst, Carrie Allen there.